Welcome back, and we are back with Harley-Davidson CEO Matt Levatich. And a surplus of motorcycles and a shift in consumer confidence caused sales to slip in the first quarter. Shares of Harley-Davidson under pressure year to date. Matt, what's your strategy in terms of attracting that next generation of riders? Yeah. Let's talk about the growth story of Harley.
That's a great, great question, Maria, because we have a headline goal in our strategy, which actually is a 10-year view of what we need to do. And that is to build the next generation of Harley-Davidson riders globally. We have five key objectives. The first is to build 2 million new riders in the United States. And so this is a focus on shifting our attention from simply we make great motorcycles to we have to be in the business of building riders and building ridership and inspiring the next generation about our sport. The second objective is to really leverage the opportunities we have outside the United States and to grow our business internationally to be 50% of the total by 2027. And then we were going to do that in part by launching 100 new high-impact motorcycles. There's a lot of focus on the number 100. I like to focus on the high-impact part because the product itself can play a really strong role in captivating the hearts and minds of different types of people, whether they're here in the United States or internationally. So we've done a lot of investment in motorcycle product development over the years to really sharpen our focus on what really moves people emotionally when we launch a new product. The third one is to deliver top quartile return on invested capital. We've done that historically very well as a company, very disciplined investments, making sure that those investments deliver returns for our shareholders. And the fifth one, which is new for us, is to grow our business without growing our environmental impact, to make sure that everything we do has an additional level of sort of environmental responsibility so that as we grow, we do not grow that impact on the planet. And that's really stimulating a lot of great creativity across our business and the things we need to do that.
Very
fuel economy being a very important one.
Of course, very, very good goals there. In terms of growing the rider population, mm-hmm. that seems like a lofty goal. How do you do that? I mean, you're an iconic company, iconic Americana, really. And so people trust the brand.
Yep.
They trust you. But how do you communicate with a population that you haven't in the past?
Well, we're really excited about it because we do this really special thing and people were recognized for it and we're in a position of great strength with our market share and our brand recognition. And it might surprise people to know that only about 2.8% of U.S. adults ride motorcycles. It's a pretty small number. So we're not talking about making that 10%. We're just talking about investing in the next generation of riders to be sure that that's at least 2.8%, maybe 3, maybe 3.5. And in the last 5-6 years, we've had a lot of tremendous success with the efforts that we've put into what we call our outreach segments. So young adults, women, African Americans, Hispanics, and really growing with them at a faster rate than we grow with our core traditional white male. And we've had great success with that. That gives us a lot of confidence that we know how to tune this and dial it in and start really investing in the broader goal of building ridership.
And once you have that rider, the rider may eventually over the years want to upgrade because you can bring them in on a low price bike, right? You can go as low as what, $7,000 for a bike?
Yep.
All the way up to what, 50,000?
Yeah. And you know, the ridership idea isn't just new riders, it's actually making sure that existing riders, or maybe somebody that's lapsed, they have a license but they don't ride anymore for some reason, get rekindled into the sport and continue to participate. I myself know that when I'm on my motorcycle riding to work, there might be one or two people in a car on the highway next to me looking at me saying, you know what, I want to ride a motorcycle. If I'm not on my bike, they're not having that thought. So getting everybody to get reconnected with why we ride, because everyone that rides really is very passionate about that experience. And so it is a broader idea than just new riders. It's riding.
Right. Well, you on your bike is a moving advertising.
It is.
All the time.
And it's a way better way to get to work. So.
How? It's true. I mean, it's true. It must be so fabulous to ride to work. Do you ride to work every day?
As often as I can. I have a statement that I make to our employees and our dealers to ride every day. And because it's tempting. You want to maybe stopping at a coffee, you know, getting your pickup truck or whatever. But take that extra step. Maybe it looks like it might rain that day. Well, we have great gear for rain. So you know, get on your bike and ride.
How important for the business is the other stuff, the gear? I mean, how important, like this leather jacket, which is gorgeous, you sell a lot of apparel at your retail shops. How important is that in terms of the overall bottom line? Right.
For a lot of reasons, it rounds out the experience, and certainly it's a good business line for us. But what we offer through the dealership is the complete package. So the dealers are able to be exclusively Harley. The customers go in, and they're in an immersive environment of Harley products, Harley accessories, the motorcycles, obviously, the events, the fellow riders that are in the dealership. So the value is a lot in the broad package. It's also in the gear itself and the role it plays in safety and comfort while you're riding. I mentioned the rain gear or helmets, you know, the ability to communicate. We have Bluetooth communication, helmet to helmet or bike to bike with your passenger or with your friend on his bike. And so this helps enhance the riding experience, make it safer, make it more comfortable. And so it's all part of, you know, lifting it up.
We're going to be watching, Matt. Great to have you on the show today.
Thank you
so much. Matthew Levatich joining us there.